Us and allowed us to be here again. We give God the praise for everything that he is doing in our lives, and we are grateful unto God for his blessings upon us. We know that he can work it out. He can work it out. And so we are grateful. Wonderful, wonderful, warm day. Everything y'all been asking for. Everything I've been asking for. Nice and hot day, amen. Don't y'all wish no cold days on us no more. But we give God the praise for what he is doing in our lives, amen. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name, amen. We are again grateful for those who are here in the sanctuary, those who might be out in the parking lot. And for those that ask, we'll be back in the parking lot on next Sunday. Amen. Next Sunday, if the Lord is willing. And I want to remind those that I already spoke to, and to those in the parking lot, Vivian and Sister Williams and whoever else might be there, and y'all here, don't y'all forget, next week is Father's Day. Y'all supposed to clap your hands. Yes, not. Hey, ain't that right, men? Y'all looked at me like I was crazy. I ain't even embarrassed. Amen. I ain't even embarrassed. Next week is Father's Day. And so I'm looking forward, amen, to the blessings that Reverend Mrs. Karen Hardaway has in store on Father's Day. Amen and amen. So y'all write that down on your calendars. And again, we thank God. Amen and amen. Our scripture for this morning comes from the gospel according to Luke chapter 18, verse 15. You know, let me begin, yes, at Luke chapter 18, verse 15. And now they were bringing even infants to him that he might touch them. And when the disciples saw it, they rebuked them. But Jesus called them to him, saying, "Let the children come to me and do not hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of God. And truly I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God like a child shall not enter it." And a ruler asked him, "A good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" And Jesus said to him, "Why do you call me amen? Why do you call me good? No one is good except God alone. You know the commandments. Do not commit adultery. Do not murder. Do not steal. Do not bear false witnesses. Honor your father and mother." And he said, "All these I have kept from my youth." When Jesus heard this, he said to him, "One thing you still lack. Sell all that you have and distribute to the poor, and you will have treasures in heaven, and come, follow me." But when he heard these things, he became very sad, for he was extremely rich. Jesus, seeing that he had become sad, said, "How difficult it is for those who have wealth to enter the kingdom of God. For it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich person to enter the kingdom of God." Those who heard it said, "Then who can be saved?" But he said, "What is impossible with men is possible with God." May God add his richest blessing to the reading and to the hearing of his word. Let us pray. Father, we come and we thank you for this day. And we thank you for the opportunity that you have blessed us to come once again to your presence. We thank you for those who are sharing with us, those who may be watching us through whatever media venue that we have made available through your grace. We pray, O God, for your blessings upon us. We pray that you bless us where we stand in a need of blessings. Father God, we need you today. We can't make this journey without you. But we thank you, O God, for your protection, and we thank you for your covering. We thank you for keeping us when we could not even keep ourselves. We pray for your service, your services on today, wherever they might be, here in Trinity and other churches that are open in your name. We pray that you bless the woman of God that will deliver your word on today. We pray for you to touch her, God, that she may be able to speak a word that will encourage us. And even if there's one that might need to be saved, they may ask that question, what must I do to be saved? Bless those who are here under the sound of my voice. Bless and keep us. And oh God, we will continue to give you praise and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. And all of God's people said, amen. Thank God and amen.
I want to feel the presence of the Lord. I go to the songs that have power. Songs that deal with the cross. Because we can't get so advanced that we forget the cross of Calvary. I don't hear you in here. We can't become so progressive that we forget it's the cross that saves. It's the cross that purchased our salvation. It was his death on the cross that made it so that we could have a right to salvation and eternity. It was the death, it was the bloody, gory, wonderful cross. They would sing, alas, and did my Savior bleed? And did my sovereign die? Would he devote that sacred head for such a worm as I? Erramos atarakondias. Was it for crimes that I had done? He hung upon a tree. What amazing pity, grace unknown, and love beyond degree. See, a lot of people don't know those verses. Drops of grief can never pay the debt of love I owe. My shame. So dear Lord, I give myself to thee. It's all that I can do. Then they would say, at the cross, at the cross. See, the generations have got to know these songs. The children have got to hear the same songs that I heard. You got to hear the old people sing, down at the cross, where my Savior died. Down where the cleansing from sin. See, you young people don't know those songs. I am so wondrously saved from my sins. Jesus so sweetly abides. There at the cross where he took me has me singing. Fountain that saves from sin. I am so glad that I am turning. It was there that Jesus saved me and keeps me clean. Has me singing.
Church said amen. Glory to his name. How many of y'all know those verses? Not many, do we? We know one or two of them. But he, Donnie McClurkin, is known for knowing every single verse of every single hymn that he sings. And so we thank God for the hymns and the hymns that have carried us. Again, we want to thank those who are watching us, remind you of your giving. Just know that you haven't forgotten. That you can give through Cash App, Givelify. You can always drop off at the church or mail to 1366 South Avenue in this city of Niagara Falls, New York, 14305. And we thank you for your giving. We remind you that when you give, you're giving on commandment to God, who said, bring ye your tithes into the storehouse that there may be meat in my house. And he says that I will open up the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing so much so that you will not have room enough to receive it. Amen. We're praying for all of our sick, and we're praying for our shut-in, as that you would keep them in your prayers. We pray for our bereaved families. Ash yesterday in Sunday school call, has there been any bad news? No bad news. So all we have is good news. And so we're grateful for that. We thank God for another day, another week of living. Amen. Do you wake up and you tell God thank you for another day? Do you tell God thank you for what he has done for you? And so we want you to be reminded that the Bible says, in all things, give thanks. In all things, give thanks. And that's what we're going to do. In all things, we are going to give thanks. Amen. There might be someone that desires prayer. We know that God is able to answer and to hear our prayers. And so we trust God to do as he has said that he will do. There is no failure. I said there is no failure in God. Anybody know that today? There is no failure in God. Let us just put our minds on the Lord. Lord, we come and we thank you for this day. And we thank you for this opportunity that you have blessed us to come and to be in your presence one more time. We thank you, O God, for everything that you have done in our lives. You didn't have to do it, but you did. And therefore we come, O God, and we give you the praise and the glory for watching over us and taking care of us. God, we come today because we know that if we've ever needed you, we need you right now. God, the road is rough and seems like sometimes the mountains seem so hard to climb. But, oh God, we come trusting. We put our faith in you. Because we know that the devil seeks to devour, destroy, to distract us. And we know that you have given us a purpose in our lives. And we are determined, oh God, to stay with you, to not turn around, nor to be distracted. Somebody needs you today in this place. Somebody needs you in this house. Somebody needs a touch from you. And oh God, we pray right now in the name of Jesus. We command by faith that you have given us that it will be done. We pray that chains will be loosened and broken. We pray, God, that things would be moved out of our way. God, we pray that doors will be opened that have been closed. We pray that the path may be clear. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, we trust that you would do it right now. No weapon that is formed against us is going to prosper. No weapon that is formed against us shall prosper. No weapon that is formed against us is going to prosper. We pray, God, that you would have your way in our lives. Have your way in our lives. Have your way in our hearts. Have your way in our bodies. Have your way on even our jobs. Have your way in our own homes. Just have your way. We welcome you, God. We desire you, oh God. We pray, oh God, that you would just come in this place, oh God, that you would touch us and that you would hear our cry. Oh God, we need you today. We can't make it without you. We come and we give you the glory. We come and give you the glory. We come to give you the glory. All of the glory, all of the glory, it belongs to you. And we thank you, oh God, for what you are doing. In Jesus' name we pray. And all of God's people said, amen and amen. Amen.
Abundantly, all you can ask or think. myself. I know he will.
He'll see
you through.
He'll see
you through.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Hallelujah. Come on and give the Lord a hand praise on today. Why? Because he is able. God is well able to see you through. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall always be in my mouth. Always, 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 always. Praise, honor, and glory belongs to God. Hallelujah. Can we take a moment one more time to give God the praise, the honor, and the glory? Such a wonderful God, such an awesome God. Hallelujah. To all officers, members, and friends of Trinity Baptist Church, praise the Lord again. To those who are in the parking lot and to those that are watching live, we are glad to have you with us on today. Always grateful for the staff here at Trinity Baptist Church. We appreciate all that you do for this ministry. And thanks to everyone for their prayers, for their words of encouragement throughout the week, whether it's by phone, whether it's by social media, whether it's by text or post. It means so much to Pastor Hardaway and I that we do have those who love and appreciate us. And we thank God for being here to be able to serve in this ministry. And so we honor our pastor on today in the person of Reverend Dr. Jimmie Hardaway Jr. Amen. Amen. Always grateful to my husband and pastor for another opportunity to stand behind this sacred desk. How many need a word from the Lord on today? Just going to let y'all in on a little conversation that I had with the Lord on this week so you guys get to just be an earshot of a conversation that I had with the Lord on today. So since you were an earshot of the conversation, well, maybe you just might go ahead and get blessed. Amen. Our text for today comes from Revelation chapter 3, verse 7. In case you didn't know, Revelation is the last book of the Bible. Amen. It's Revelation. We begin in Genesis and just start flicking through the pages. Go all the way to the last book of the Bible. Hallelujah. That's Revelation chapter 3, verse 7. Revelation chapter 3, verse 7. Reading from the King James Version, just one portion of scripture, one verse. The word of the Lord reads on this wise, "And to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, these things says he who is holy, he who is true, he who has the key of David, he who opens and no one shuts, and shuts and no one opens." May the Lord bless the reader and the hearer of his holy word. For a few moments, I want to talk about the blessing behind closed doors. The blessing behind closed doors. The blessing behind closed doors. Now, I just believe that, you know, we might have a few little empty pews here, but I know that there's somebody that you're sitting next to. So how I used to do before the pandemic, I used to say, well, neighbor, go ahead and look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, the blessing is behind closed doors. All right, Brother Ken is sitting in the back. So maybe somebody in the front can turn around and look at them and say, Bonnie and Brother Campbell, the blessing is behind closed doors. Hallelujah. Come on and put your hands together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just feel right now that Pastor needs to be encouraged. I need everybody in the sanctuary to go ahead and look at Pastor and say, Pastor, the blessing is behind closed doors. Come on and give it up for the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's for somebody watching and for somebody who may be in the parking lot. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. We know that you have the power to produce the blessing behind closed doors. So, Father, I'm just going to go ahead and get out of the way. And I pray, oh God, that it's not even me being seen up here today. But, Father, I pray that it's your power and your spirit that's being seen and heard. So, Father, I come against any opposition today. I come against anything that will try to hinder your word from going forth. God, the weapon may form, but it ain't gonna prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. The enemy tried it this week, oh God, but I stand here as a witness that no weapon formed against me shall be able to prosper, and no weapon formed against your word shall be able to prosper. So, Father, I need you to set the atmosphere with fire from the Holy Ghost. Now, God, I need to put my angels, hallelujah, goodness and mercy, in the back, oh God, and on my side and in my front to cover and to hover in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, God, I'm just going to let them listen in on a conversation that we had, God, about the blessing being behind closed doors. So, Father, I thank you in advance for the word that's going to go forth today. Let it fall on good ground. And if you love him, say amen. The writer of the book of Revelation is none other than the disciple John. This is the disciple that Jesus loved. Now, notably, the New Testament book, this book is the revelation of Jesus Christ, and in it are details of the prophetic events concerning the consummation of his redemptive work with signs and symbols following. The Bible says in chapter 1, I, John, both your brother and companion in the tribulation and kingdom and patience of Jesus Christ, was on the island that is called Patmos for the word of God and for the testimony of Jesus Christ. John says that I was in the spirit on the Lord's day, and I heard behind me a voice as a trumpet saying, I am the Alpha and the Omega. I am the first and the last. And what you see, write in a book. Hallelujah. And send it to the seven churches who are in Asia. These are the seven churches: Ephesus, Smyrna, Pergamos, Thyatira, Sardis, Philadelphia, and to Laodicea. Here's the biblical text. Let's set it up for the today. John was exiled on the island of Patmos. He was secluded away from society so that he could know by the Spirit of God what was happening in the seven churches as well as their outcome. However, time will not allow for me to exegete the text on the behavior within these churches, but here are a few observations of what was happening or not happening in them. First, we start with the Ephesus church. This church was known as the loveless church. The Bible says that, nevertheless, I have this against you, that you have left your first love. The first love here refers to Jesus Christ. Second, we have the church in Smyrna. This church was known as the persecuted church. The Bible says that, do not fear
any of those things which are you are about to suffer. Indeed, the devil is about to throw some of you into prison that you may be tested, and you will have tribulation 10 days. Be faithful unto death, and I will give you the crown of life. Third, we have the Pergamos church. This church was known as the compromising church. The Bible says, but I have a few things against you, because you have there those who hold the doctrine of Balaam, who taught Balak to put a stumbling block before the children of Israel, to eat things sacrificed to idols, and to commit sexual immorality. Thus, you also have those who hold to the doctrine of Nicolaitan, which thing I hate. And Nicolaitan in the Bible means a liar. So God hates a liar. He said, repent, or else I will come to you quickly and will fight against them with the sword of my mouth. I'm talking about the seven churches. Fourth, we have the church in Thyatira, known as the corrupt church. God must have knew that there was going to be some corruption going on in churches today. The Bible says, nevertheless, I have a few things against you, because you allow that woman Jezebel, who calls herself a prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants. May I report to you that Jezebel can be a male as well as a female. The Bible says, I gave her time to repent of her sexual immorality, and she did not repent. Indeed, I will cast her into a sick bed, and those who commit adultery with her into great tribulation, unless they repent of their deeds. I will kill her children, and I will cause the churches to know that I am he who searches the minds and hearts, and I will give each one according to their works. Next we have the Sardis church. This church was known as a dead church. I tried to skip over the Sardis church. I was trying to get to the church of Philadelphia, but I had to talk about the Sardis church. The Bible says that these things says he who has seven spirits of God and seven stars. I know your works, that you have a name, that you are alive, but you are dead. Nothing was moving in the church. It was dead. The name was on the outside, but there was nothing happening on the inside. The Bible says that it was a dead church. Then we have the church of Laodicea. This was known as a lukewarm church. This was a church where they would patty cake God. This was a church where they wouldn't praise God. This was a church that they'd be like, amen. You preaching a day. Amen. The Bible says, I know your works, that you are neither hot nor cold. I could wish that you were either hot or cold. So then, because you are lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I'm going to vomit you out of my mouth. Ladies and gentlemen, those are the few observations of the sixth church. Which brings me to my assignment to the Church of Philadelphia. This church was known as a faithful church. The Bible says in chapter 3, verse 7, and to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, these things says he who is holy, he who is true, he who has the key of David, he who opens and no one shuts, and shuts and no one opens. Put those hands together for the blessing behind closed doors. I'm almost through. This pandemic alone has caused some doors to be closed, including the doors of most churches. Furthermore, there were many reasons as to why the pandemic happened. One group said this, another group said that, not to mention certain religious groups who had their own opinion as to why the pandemic happened. But all I know is that God wanted to see how we as Christians would act behind closed doors. Since there were no worship service, no afternoon programs, no church anniversaries, no teas, no brunches, no musicals, God wanted to see how we would act behind closed doors. He closed the doors so we could talk to him, not come up here with religious rhetoric, but he wanted a real conversation where our guards were down, where our transparency would be in the open, where we could worship him, where we could praise him. The song says, just a talk with Jesus will make everything all right. But were you shut up with him, or were you suffering from some type of anxiety because life as you knew it was on hold? Now that some of the restrictions have been lifted and some churches have reopened, there appears to be no change. How so? There ain't no power, my God. There ain't no worship. Come on and help me, Holy Ghost. There is no healing. There is no deliverance whatsoever. There is no joy. People walking here tired, got attitudes, just dressed up, but they dead. They ain't got no joy, ain't got no peace. It is the same spiritually dry atmosphere as it was before the pandemic. But if you were behind closed doors, then something should be happening by the time your feet hit the pavement. I mean, your presence alone should be powerful enough to change the atmosphere. In doing so, we would enter his gates with thanksgiving. We would enter his courts with praise. We would be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the blessing, the blessing is behind closed doors. I'm almost through. I got to get out of here. But I'm looking. Maybe you're watching. Maybe you're in a parking lot. But I'm looking, I'm checking. Here go the conversation. I'm looking for a few folk who knows that the blessing is behind closed doors. Come on and put those hands together, because I got to get out of here. I need to know, is there anybody who knows that the blessing is behind closed doors? Hallelujah, hallelujah. It's behind closed doors that the hard lessons are learned. It's behind closed doors where the battles are fought. It's behind closed doors where the hard testing occurs. It's behind closed doors where God can really see if you're saved for real. The Bible says, I am the door. If anyone enters through me, he shall be saved. He shall go in and out and find pastures. Behind closed doors. True believers don't have to put on an act before God. He can see past the wigs. He can see past the nails. He can see past the social media posts. He can see past the eyelashes. He can see past the clothes. It's behind closed doors that true believers are overcome and be victorious. Yet, we want God to hurry up and open the door. We want God to open up that door so quick so we can get the hell out of here. Come on, God, and open up the door. Come on, God, hurry up and open up the door. We don't want to go through nothing. We don't want to be persecuted. We don't want to go through tribulation. We just want God to open up the door so we can tell the world, look at me. The devil is a liar. Ladies and gentlemen, do not get in a hurry for God to open the door. Do not be in a hurry to have your behind go through a door that God has already closed. God wants you to stay behind the door so that you can come out right. Hallelujah. But sometimes, God does open the door. The Bible says that God opens the doors and he shuts the doors. But sometimes he closes the doors. And behind closed doors is a blessing. If the door is open too soon, we might really miss the blessing that God has for us. I promise you that I'm about to get out of here. Here go my last point. The blessing is behind closed doors. Maybe you didn't catch it. Maybe somebody watching, but the blessing is behind closed doors. The blessing is behind closed doors. Did you hear what I said? I said the blessing is behind closed doors. Hallelujah. The Bible says, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Behind closed doors, behind closed doors, behind closed doors, behind closed doors, behind closed doors. The Bible said that weeping may endure for a night, but joy, I said joy, I said joy, 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 joy is behind closed doors. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible says, Revelation 3:7, he who opens and no one shuts, and shuts and no one opens. All I stop by to say is be encouraged, because the blessing is behind closed doors. I said the blessing is behind closed doors. The blessing, the blessing, the blessing, the blessing, the blessing, the blessing, the blessing is behind closed doors. Not only is the blessing behind closed doors, but there's power behind closed doors. Your answer is behind closed doors. Your breakthrough is behind closed doors. Your deliverance is behind closed doors. Oh, but the victory, I said victory, victory is behind closed doors. Victory is behind closed doors. Victory shall be mine. I said victory shall be mine. I told Satan, get thee behind closed doors. Victory shall be mine. Hallelujah. Victory shall be mine. Ooh, the victory. Ooh, the victory shall be mine. Not only do you have power, not only do you have breakthrough, not only do you have deliverance, not only is your answer behind closed doors, Jesus is behind the closed door. Behind closed doors. Behind closed doors. Come on and put your hands together if you believe it today. Behind closed doors. Behind closed doors. Behind closed doors. Behind closed doors. That should be in your mouth all day. Tomorrow, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and by the time you get here next week to help Pastor celebrate Father's Day, the blessing is behind closed doors. Whoa, 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 behind closed doors. Hallelujah, the blessing is behind closed doors. Hallelujah. I got to get out of here. At Calvary, the enemies of Jesus thought they had him. They stood by while the soldiers nailed his feet to the cross, while they nailed his hands to the cross, while they put the crown of thorns on his head. They thought that they had him. The enemies of Jesus was religious folk. His body was placed in a borrowed tomb. But something was happening in that tomb. Something was happening behind the doors of the tomb. Come on, think about it. Jesus was behind closed doors in a tomb Friday night, Saturday afternoon, Saturday night, but early, my God, from on high. The tomb door was open. That tomb door was open because what was behind the door was my Jesus and your Jesus, who had all power to show us that behind closed doors is where you really get the breakthrough. Come on, put your hands together. Behind closed doors. Hallelujah. That's all I stopped by today to say. Was the blessing is behind closed doors. The blessing is behind closed doors. I decree and declare a blessing over each and every one that is in this room, to those that are in the parking lot, and to those that are watching. The blessing is behind closed doors. Come on and put your hands together. Father, I thank you. Thank you, God, that you allowed these, your people, to listen in on a conversation that me and you had all week long. God, I know I wanted to be selfish because I wanted to share, God, what you shared with me in the name of Jesus, that the blessing is behind closed doors. God, if we remain faithful to you and not be in a hurry for everybody to see us, God, when you open up the door, the manifestation of what happened behind closed doors, the glory will go to nobody but you. So God, I thank you that you have allowed me to stand behind this sacred desk to decree that the blessing is behind closed doors. Thank you that you have allowed me to stand to say that the blessing is behind closed doors. Thank you that you have given me the strength to open up my mouth, and what poured out of my belly is that the blessing is behind closed doors. The blessing is behind closed doors. God, somebody is watching. Somebody is watching. Somebody is watching and saying, I want my blessing. I want it. I don't want to be seen too soon. Maybe I need to get off social media for a while, because I don't want nobody to see what you're doing for me in the open. It's behind closed doors, God, that I need to be tested. I need to be tried. I need you to see that I'm faithful to you, God. I don't want the applause from man. I don't want people applauding me. In my flesh dwells no good thing, but God, your power, your authority, your goodness, your grace, oh God, destroys every yoke. So I thank you in the name of Jesus. Pour out your blessing on your people, God. Those who want it, God. For those who don't want it, pass them by and give it to the one who does want it in the name of Jesus. I pray, oh God, that you would bless this church. I pray, oh God, that every church that's watching, I pray that you would bless, God, all the way from Africa, God, to the hills of Alabama. So, Father, I thank you right now in the mighty name of Jesus. If you're loving people of God, come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God, all praise and honor belongs to you. There may be somebody who's saying, I want to get behind the closed door. I want it to be just me and Jesus. God, if you say who you say that you are, then you show me who you are behind closed doors. Because if I accept you and invite you into my heart, and when I come before the people publicly, I can say that it was nobody but God. You can call this church 716 area code 285-0743. If you can't make it, type on the screen, I want to be saved. I want a relationship with God. I want to be changed. I don't want to be part of a dead church. I don't want to be part of a corrupt church. I don't want to be part of a loveless church. You just walk in and people mean and walk past you and don't even speak. I don't want to be part of that kind of church. I want to be part of a church that's faithful. I want to be part of a church where God is. I want to be part of a church where there's love. There is no perfect church, but if Jesus is in it, he can help you. So pray a simple prayer. Father, come into my heart. I believe that I'm a sinner. And I believe by faith that you died on that cross of Calvary for me. And since I believe that you died on the cross of Calvary, Jesus live in me. Jesus breathe in me. Jesus talk in me. Jesus walk in me. Jesus change my heart from a hard heart to a soft heart. So I can be ready when you return. If you prayed that prayer, you are part of the family of God. Come on and let me know that you did it. Just type it on the screen and let me know that you prayed that prayer of faith. And if you have to go back and listen to it again, put it on pause and go back. Come on and put your hands together. Hallelujah. Services are now turned over to our pastor, the Reverend Jimmie Hardaway Jr. Come on and give it up for the man of God.
Church said amen. Come on, let's amen again. Put your hands together. Let's give God some praise. We'll trust in the Lord until I die. Till I die. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord until I die. I'm going to treat everybody right. I'm going to treat everybody right. Gonna treat everybody right until I die. I'm going to treat everybody right. Gonna treat everybody right. Going to treat everybody right till I die. Y'all help me say, I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. Until I die, I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord till I die. And the church said, amen. I tried it. I tried it. But we thank God, amen. I'll sing with a track if I gotta sing. But I I tried it. So we thank God for the day. We thank God for Reverend Karen Hardaway, who preached to us on today. And we thank God for each and every one of you who shared with us on this morning. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. And we just praise him and praise him and praise him, because we're going to give God the praise. Amen. I'm going to go home and practice and be ready next week. Amen. But we thank God for you. Thank God for those on the outside that shared with us on today. And we continue to give God all of the praise and all of the glory. Continue to pray for one another, pray for our sick and our shut-in, and continue to lift up the Trinity Baptist Church. Thank you to those who have shared with us on this morning, that watched us live, and those who will watch us this week. We thank God for you. And don't y'all forget, coming up is Father's Day. Let's pray. Father, we come in the name of Jesus, and we thank you for this day. We thank you for what you have done. And we pray, oh God, that you would bless us, oh God, as we go forward in your name, that you would keep us in your care. God, we come and we give you all of the praise. We come, we give you all of the glory. And now we pray, God, that you would walk, guide, and hold our hands as we move forward. In Jesus' name we pray. And the people of God said, amen. Amen. God bless you. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.